Very good morning to one and all. Today I am going to explain the module number 1, that is basic of communication system. Previous lecture we introduced the concept, or we start with the syllabus introduction and marking scheme of a subject, principle of communication engineering. Same for branch electronics and telecommunication for Mumbai University. So today we'll start first module, that is basic of communication system. So before going to this lecture, we ask one question to all of you. What is meant by communication? In many times we hear or we can listen this word communication in many times in day to day life. Think it or give me answer or chat box on reply or personally. So basically the word communication is come from communicate, which refer to pass and communicating. The term communication, which is familiar with everyday of life, we are interested in communicating some information which may include the thoughts, news, feeling, so on others. So broad sense terms, communication refers to transmit the information from one place to another place. So communication means there is a transfer of information from one place to another place in the form of information, maybe news, feelings and others, etc. So information transmission between maybe human sitting very close, or may take place via one or more following means, in the form of speech, facial expression or gesture. So most of the effective is via speech mode. However, the speech of mode communication is also limited by how loud a person can produce a speech signal very effectively. For long distance communication, initially human beings are employed in non-electrical means like drum, beat, smoke signal, running message, horses, all this. Electrical means a communication start with wire telegraphy in 1814, developing a telephony decades in 1817, radio being in 20 centuries. So that is nothing but the communication system. So that is called as a communication. So communication means transmission of information from one place to another place. The information is maybe form of facsimile, speech, audio, video or picture. So that is called as communication. Now the basic outline of this lecture, block diagram of basic communication system, then we also go to the electromagnetic spectrum and signal bandwidth and power. So first we introduce the basic block diagram of communication system. So communication is a simply basic process exchange the information. The electronics equipment which are used communication purpose called communication equipment. Different communication equipment are assembled together to communication system. Typical example of communication system is line telephony. So here the basic block diagram we can see. So it consists of information source, input transducer, transmitter, channel, receiver, output transducer and one of the noise. So what is the information source? The essential component of the communication system: information source, input transducer, transmitter, communication channel, receiver and destination. Now we shall discuss function of each block separately. First one is the information source. As we know, a communication system serves to communicate a message or information. This information is originated from the information source. In general, there can be various messages in the form of words, group of words, code symbol, sound signal. However, out of this message, only desired message selected and communicated. Therefore, we can say that the function of information source is produced the required message which is to be transmitted over a transmitter through channel, then input transducer. Already we know that what is meant by transducer in previous semester. So transducer is a device which converts one form of energy into another form. The message from the information source may or may not be electrical in nature. In case when the message produced by the information source is not in electrical in nature, that time the input transducer is used to convert into a time-varying electrical signal. So that is the main function of input transducer, to convert any non-electrical signal into electrical signal. That is called as a transducer. For example, in case of radio broadcasting, the microphone converts information into message, which is form of sound waves into corresponding electrical signal. So acoustic signal of sound or audio signal which convert into electrical signal with the help of microphone. Then we go to the transmitter, that is the third block of basic communication system. Function of the transmitter is processed electrical signal from different aspect. For example, in radio broadcasting, the electrical signal obtained from the sound signal is processed and restricted into audio frequency up to 5 kHz in amplitude modulation radio broadcast, often is amplified. In wire telephony, there is a low rear processing is needed. However, the long distance radio communication signal amplification is necessary before modulation. So modulation is the main function of the transmitter. Modulation in message signal is superimposed upon the high frequency of the carrier. In short, we can say that inside the transmitter, the signal processing such as restriction of range of audio frequencies, amplification and modulation are achieved in transmitter side. All this processing, the message signal are done just easy to transmit signal through the channel. So this is all about the transmitter. So what type of process will be done at a transmitter in basic communication system? These are three processes. First one is the restriction of the range of the audio frequencies, amplification and modulation are achieved, three processes at the transmitter side. Then channel and noise. The term channel means the medium through which the message travels from transmitter to receiver. Or we can say, in another words, we can say that the function of channel is to provide the physical connection between transmitter and receiver. That is called as a channel, or we can say media. There are two types of channels, namely point-to-point channel and broadcast channels. Example of point-to-point channels are wire lines, microwave links, optical fibers are the examples of point-to-point channels. Wire lines operate by guided electromagnetic waves and they are used to locate a telephone transmission. In case microwave links, transmitted signal is radiated as a form of electromagnetic wave in free space. Microwave links are used to long distance telephone transmission. An optical fiber is low loss, well controlled, guided optical medium. So optical fibers are used for the optical communication. Although these are the three channels operated differently, they are provide physical medium for the transmission signal from one point to another point. Therefore, these channels are termed as point to point. On another hand, the broadcast channels provide the capability where several receiving stations can be reached simultaneously from single transmitter. The example of broadcast channel is a satellite geostationary orbit, which is covers 1/3 Earth of the surface. So basically in channel we can classify into point to point, where the guided media, and for broadcast channel we use mostly unguided media. Unguided media means there is no physical relation, physical medium present between transmitter to receiver. And in guided media, there is a physical medium present between transmitter and receiver. So point to point, a guided media will be used, or guided channel will be used. For broadcast channel, we will be use unguided media. That is to be remembered while dealing with the MCQ. Then noise. What is in the noise? Noise is an unwanted electrical signal generated or added during a transmission of data from transmitter to receiver. That is called as a noise. During the process of transmission and reception of signal gets distorted due to noise introduced in the system. Noise is an unwanted signal which is tend to interface with the required signal. Noise signal always random in characteristics. Noise may be interface with the signal at a point in communication system. However, the noise has been greatest effect in signal in the channel. Then receiver. The main function of the receiver to reproduce the message signal in the form of electrical, which from distorted to the distorted received signal. This reproduction of the original signal is accompanied by the process known as demodulation or detection. Demodulation is the reverse process of modulation carried out at the transmitter. Then destination. Destination is the final stage which is used to convert electrical message into original form. For example, radio broadcasting, the destination is a loudspeaker which works as a transducer which convert electrical signal into original and sound signal. That is an example of reverse transducer. So today we also decide what is meant by electromagnetic spectrum, and electromagnetic spectrum plays important role in radio communication, satellite communication, or in optical communication, all these things. So first we define what is meant by electromagnetic spectrum. The electromagnetic spectrum is a range of all types of electromagnetic radiation. The radiation is energy that travels and spread out. It goes in visible light that comes from lamps in your house and the radios that comes from the radio station. There are two types of electromagnetic radiation. The another types of electromagnetic radiation that make up the electromagnetic spectrum are microwaves, infrared light, ultraviolet light, X-rays and gamma rays. So this table gives the electromagnetic spectrum classified in terms of different frequency ranges corresponding the wavelength range, nomenclature and typical application of this. For example, the frequency range of electromagnetic spectrum from 30 hertz to 3000 terahertz. So the wavelength also will be mentioned, and their electromagnetic spectrum nomenclature, that is like for 0.3 hertz to 3 kilohertz, the wavelength range from 10 to power 6 to 10 to power 5 meter, the voice frequency, and it is used for face-to-face speech communication or intercom. That is a typical application. So this is the classification, broad classification of electromagnetic spectrum along with the frequency range, wavelength range, and electromagnetic spectrum nomenclature and typical applications. Then we go to the signal bandwidth and power. So what is meant by bandwidth? Simply we can define it is a difference between upper band, upper frequency and lower frequency in continuous band frequencies. Or we can say that it is a difference between upper band, upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency. It is typically measured in hertz. Depending on the construct, may be specifically referred as pass bandwidth or baseband bandwidth. Passband bandwidth is a difference between the upper and lower cutoff frequencies. For example, band pass filter of communication channel or signal spectrum. Baseband bandwidth applies to low pass filter, the baseband signal. The bandwidth is equal to the upper cutoff frequency. So bandwidth is nothing but the difference between upper frequency minus lower frequency, it is the bandwidth. Bandwidth in hertz is a central concept. Many fields, including electronics, information theory, digital communication, radio communication, signal processing, spectroscopy, and is one of the determines the capacity of the given communication channel. So bandwidth, which gives the communication channel capacity. So bandwidth is very important in communication channel. Then power. The transmitted power is the average of the transmitted signal. The channel bandwidth reflects on the band significant frequency component allocated for the transmission of the input message signal. The power is defined how much amount of signal will be transmitted from transmitter to receiver in terms of the power, or we can calculate the device how much power is consumed in terms of the bandwidth whenever it will be increase or decrease. So this is all about the basic block diagram of communication system, then electromagnetic spectrum, then we define what is the bandwidth and what is the power. So in this lecture we introduce three concepts. So we can stop here. Thank you.